Learn more on BBC Bitesize.
Hello and welcome to BBC Bitesize GCSE Physics. I'm James Stewart, a TV presenter and climate expert.
And I'm Ellie Hurer, a bioscience PhD researcher. We're here to help you with your physics and combined science GCSE.
Yes, we are. In this video, we'll be exploring thermal insulation for your exam.
And don't I know it?
Yes, Ellie, I was going to ask you this. Why are you wearing so many layers?
I put my thermals on, although it's a bit too warm. I'm starting to struggle to move in all these coats. Have you ever wondered how your takeaway hot drinks from the local coffee shop stay hot?
Yeah, actually, I have.
Or how some single-use takeaway cups are less effective? It's all because of thermal insulation.
Thermal insulation is essential for reducing heat transfers in all sorts of places. For example, between the interior and exterior of buildings, insulated cups and drinks flasks, like this one.
Insulators work in two main ways. They keep things hot by reducing heat loss from a hot object, and they keep things cool by reducing heat transfer to a cold object from its surroundings.
But how can we find out the best way to reduce heat transfer, I hear you ask?
How can we find out the best way to reduce heat transfer, James?
Well, I'm glad you've asked me. Ellie, it's time to don our coats. Sit me in the face. To the lab.
James. We don't actually have a lab.
I know that, but they don't know that. We're adding a fancy wipe in the edit, which will make it look like we're in a new space and not in the same area, just slightly differently, okay?
Gosh, they're so clever. To the lab!
Hello, we are back. This way. Yes, we are going to test the thermal conductivity of different materials to check their effectiveness at reducing heat loss or gain.
Materials with high thermal conductivity have a high energy transfer rate, so they are poor insulators. But if they have a low conductivity, they are effective insulators.
You might want to pause this bit in a second just to make sure you've got everything, because for this experiment, you will need the following things. A stopwatch. Different materials for testing insulation. You could use newspaper, bubble wrap, or something like cotton wool. A funnel, a piece of card, a measuring cylinder, elastic bands, a thermometer, large beaker, small beaker, and a kettle.
A word of warning, guys. Don't sit down to perform this experiment just in case you spill the hot water, which would not be good.
Very bad. So the control variables are the ones that we keep the same. So in this case, that's the volume of water, the starting temperature of the water, and the thickness of the insulating material. So, we need, Ellie, 80 cubic centimetres of hot water.
I'm on it.
Thank you. It's a job for an adult. No, I'm not qualified, quite honestly. Here she comes. Right,
here
lovely
it
stuff.
Is.
Thank you. 80 cubic centimetres.
Yes.
Okay, so I am now going to pour that hot water into this smaller beaker using this funnel and my measuring cylinder. We're looking for 80. Tell me when we're there.
Right, keep going.
I haven't even started.
Slow. Almost there. Stop.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah, that's fine.
She's the expert.
For the control, we're going to put that into the beaker with no insulation, which is this one.
Small beaker?
Yes, please.
No insulation. Done.
We're then going to put a small hole into a piece of card, which has to be big enough to fit the thermometer. We now need to place the card on top with the elastic
band. Right, you do the band. Yes.
Perfect. Right. Please place the thermometer for me.
Yep. Okay, so as you can see, we have added the thermometer in, so we can now check the temperature. To achieve a consistent starting temperature, we wait until the temperature drops to 70 degrees Celsius before we start the experiment. And
gotcha.
We have a little way to go.
When that's ready, we're going to start our stopwatch and record the temperature of the water every 2 minutes for 10 minutes. Right, should we go get a cup of tea while we wait? Sounds good.
Actually, we could take this water with us, couldn't we? That's boiling.
Yeah.
Oh, we are at 70 degrees, my friend, which means
get in.
You can start the stopwatch,
oh,
Ellie.
Thank you.
2 minutes.
Ready? Go.
Go.
Right, let's take our first reading.
Thank you.
Now that we've got our first set of readings, we're going to repeat the experiment, but we're going to add our first insulating material. So we've picked newspaper. So just before this, we've cooled down our water again to 70 degrees Celsius, and James will be placing the beaker into the newspaper, making sure the newspaper covers all of the water. Perfect.
Yeah. Start the clock once again. We have good news. We've repeated the experiment with both cotton wool, and I'll give you that one, and with bubble wrap as the insulators.
After recording our results, we're going to plot our cooling curves, which is the temperature in degrees Celsius on the y-axis against the time in minutes on the x-axis. The water will cool down at the slowest rate with the most effective insulator. We can see on our graph that this has the shallowest gradient, therefore has the lowest rate of energy transfer. The higher the final line position, the more effective the insulator.
In this case, it looks like we have a winner. Drum roll, please. It's the cotton wool. Surprised?
Nope.
Nope, not at all, because it has the lowest thermal conductivity of all these materials. Well done to the cotton wool. Most insulators work by trapping a layer of air. The thermal conductivity of air is low as long as it's not free to move. So the more that we can trap within our insulator, the less heat transfer will occur. Rest my case.
So there you have it. Hopefully that helps you understand thermal insulation a bit more, and hopefully you'll feel a bit more prepared for your physics and combined science GCSE.
Sorry, I just thought something. Why did the metal pan and the woolly jumper break up?
I don't know why.
Because they've got no thermal chemistry. What, one was too hot to handle, yeah? The other just wasn't feeling it because the thermal, yeah.
That's terrible. Please don't ever say that again.
I'm better than that, aren't I? Am I? BBC. Thanks. If you want to find out more, even more, about thermal conductivity or any other modules for your combined science exams, then head over to the BBC Bitesize website. The link is
down below.
It is.
And we'll see you guys next time. Bye. Bye.
For in-depth GCSE resources and practice, visit BBC Bitesize now.